Yes, I will. Hello, good morning. Very good morning to all my. Very good morning to all my colleagues at University of Babylon, Iraq. Lot of loves and respect from India. This is Dr. Kusal Das, Professor of Physiology, BLD, deemed to be university, from India in front of you. First of all, I like to convey my sincere thanks to University of Babylon to invite me to deliver the keynote on this great occasion of today. I am sorry, I regret that I could not able to arrive in your lovely country due to my health. But I'm thankful to University of Babylon for arranging the Skype meeting in front of you. My special thanks to my longtime friend, Professor Dr. Ala Al-Charak. Thank you very much, Professor Al-Charak. Let me start the topic which has been decided. The topic today is ethical teaching in medical sciences in global perspective. A warm greetings to University of Babylon. This is my institution's medical school under my university. The teaching is the noblest of all professions in the world. All of us, we agree with that. And we are involving directly or indirectly in the profession as such. If we really find out the essential quality of a teacher, in general, I want to say about the general teacher as such, from the primary school to university or in the professional universities like University of Babylon or my university, BLD deemed to be university. The teacher essential quality remains same. It's a role model. Teacher is a role model. Teacher's character is one of the very important issues which we always consider. And definitely we will find that next is teacher's personality, which also makes really matters. If you really ask you to remember one of the role model teacher in your life, all of you will, I'm sure, will find at least one who has inspired you, motivate you, and bring you today's in this profession to become a successful medical teacher. One of the important quality besides his personality, character, is the mental health. This is one of the important issues for any teacher as such. Teacher's social adjustment is very important. How social the teacher is, we really want to know it, because teacher is a part of an university or an institution or a professional medical institutions like us, where students, apart from students, colleagues, other professionals and patients overall, and the society as such in a large, are involved. So social adjustment of a medical teacher or any teacher is an important. And definitely, when we think of a teacher, first we remember how best the teacher has been taught us and how best he is as a teacher. And when we think of how best he is a teacher, the point which you remember, that is how knowledgeable he is. So knowledge is an important domain for any teacher of any profession, from primary school to university, everywhere. Teacher must be a knowledgeable, resourceful person at first. So this, and secondly, when it comes to the professional, then teacher's ability in academic ability and professional ability as a doctor, both counts, and how teacher works in the both the domain as a knowledge imparer as well as the dissipating the understanding of clinical skills to the doctors, students, tomorrow's doctor, that also need to be counted. Here, my dear colleague, I just like to emphasize one of the greatest medical teacher in this art, Professor Ronald Hardin. His sketch and diagram has given the 12 role model of a medical teacher. If you see, you'll be finding that this circle incited having the 6 major component. One, teacher as a facilitator, role model, information provider, resource developer, planner, and assessor. Further subclassification of facilitator have the 2 role, as a mentor and learning facilitator. Role model has the 2 role. On the job role model, how the teacher is a teacher and doctor himself, how, what he does, how he interact with the patients, colleague, other colleagues, experts, that's induce the conception of the role model inside or imbibe on the students. And the teaching role model, definitely we all remember our great teacher in medical school who have taught us in different discipline of medicine so wisely. We follow them, and today when we teach medical sciences in any discipline, we just remember our role model teacher. So this is one of the very important component. Then it comes to the information provider, that is as a lecturer, also as a clinical practitioner teacher, which I have mentioned. Resource developer, we will find the resource material creator, research material creator, and study guide producer. Then planner, this is the part of an important part of a teacher, any medical teaching. Curriculum planner and course organizer. These 2 is a very important for the students, whether he is in presence or in at a distance. This is important. And teaching expertise, that exactly comes as an assessor. This is a critical part. How we assess our medical students from preclinical or basic medical sciences to clinical medicine, from bench to bedside teaching, how we do, that's important issues. So these are 12 important characters or roles of a medical teacher expert Ronald Hardin. In a profession, when it characterizes, we find that teacher requires a long period of academic training, and this makes a teacher perfect as long as he is involved in professional teaching with the students in the classroom to the clinics, in all the sites, how best he is involved. An organized body of knowledge on which undertaking is based. A profession is characterized an appropriate duration of format and rigorous professional training with practical experience in the field. Yes, the experience counts the most. That is the reason we require to be enriched with our experience, not only in our home countries, our internal colleagues, but also the external and international colleagues, more we should be exposed to get more training, more perfect in the professional aspects. And last of all, definitely a profession is enriched by professional ethics itself. Now, the main question comes, that is, what exactly mean by ethical teaching? That is the important topic of discussion today. We are aware of research, medical ethics, research ethics, publication ethics, clinical ethics, but hardly we bother about the teaching ethics or teaching ethically to the students. This is one part which medical teachers is really need to be upgraded and more informed and more should be understandable about these issues. The point is how medical teacher differs from other teacher. A medical teacher is also a teacher like any other discipline, but the teacher-student relationship and interactive performance, it differs. Yes, here we are different from the other university, other branches teaching, because our students and ourselves, when you teach, we closely teach with each other. We are very closer of many of the aspects. Point by point, we discuss, we show them all the skills directly and all the skills involve the human, where the life and death in between a teacher teaches as a teacher plus a professional simultaneously. So here the interaction between student and physician teachers are quite different from other professions. So we are definitely different. Teaching from classroom to bedside, yes, it's a dynamic process. Essence of ethical teaching in medicine. Teaching ethics mean to intertwine learning and relations. Both should be there at simultaneously. Medical teacher teaches not only the subject, but also the whole surroundings, objects, and ultimate goal, and also the exact what going to be happening and what is the pros and cons, everything. So there is a different status required between the teaching part to the medical professionals. Teaching ethics means to use experience to the student's best. Yes, your own experiences can be valuable in the understanding your student, but you should never let your own feeling. This is the important point. A great teacher teaches in the two way, one from his own knowledge, that is the primary needs of any teacher. Second from his own understanding by rich experience. But one cannot get the rich experience immediately. It needs stages. There's a reason long time exposure, being a teacher is an important and essential. This experience actually gives teaching in a different way, because we teach the student, medical student who are directly involved to healthcare and exposed to the professional once they come out from the medical school. So our teaching, any point is error if it is there, and if it is not prerogative to the student's understanding perfectly, if we do not discuss as we never thought of it, this will definitely make an impact on the student itself in the future. So we should be very careful for teaching parts, that how ethically we should teach, means what exactly we should impart, what we should restrain ourselves, how we should behave, how we should act, how we should handle an issue from basic science to clinical medicine, all the things students learn at a time, and they learn how ethically we have treated them as well as our colleague, as well as the patient themselves. Teaching ethics brings the responsibility. So when we know that we have certain limit, we have certain restriction, we have to restrain ourselves from certain points, but we have the obligation of teaching and giving the knowledge to the student and make them understand the skills of teaching, research, and practice. In such case, we must know that what exactly our responsibility. So sense of ethics gives a responsibility also. A medical teacher get more responsible when he knows that how ethically he should work in an environment of healthcare in respect to his own university, hospitals, country, or globally. Because medical profession does not have any border as such. It is beyond the border. So a doctor has no country or any state itself. The profession is the noblest profession. So one has to cross. So because of that, our sense of knowledge also should be imbibed with the sense of ethics. And then only we can be a good teacher and a good physician simultaneously. Learn to teach ethically. This is one important point where first is disposition, self-motivated, self-understanding. That I must be aware that what I should do to my student, how much I should work, what I should give in this point, and where I should ask my student to restrain, and why I should myself be restrained for further advancing the knowledge or further advancing of the skill. I should know that two things. One, I'm teaching the student, other I'm handling the patient. So simultaneously I have to see whether it should not overlap each other and affect the health and spirit of the student as well as the patient directly when we are teaching in the bedside. So we should be very careful and restrained. We need to be judgment in a very balancing act, and we must introspect ourselves, what we have done, what we are doing for the profession as such. The code of ethics for the medical teacher as such, we will be finding the standard code of ethics for medical practice for the medical teacher. It has the code of ethics. Code of ethics, code of conduct, and professional practice, in which these three components are very important. One is integrity, second is the respect, third is the responsibility. The code of teaching ethics, if you further go, will find a teacher is constantly under the scrutiny of his students and the society. Yes, this is one of the medical teaching profession's issue, that we are not only watched by the students what we are teaching, but also society want to know whom we have taught, how much they have learned, and what skill they are imparting on them for service. So we are always under watchdog for the society looking at us in a different way. Medical teachers and the student, when it comes, definitely the second point, there must be a love and respect to academic performance itself. Encourage students to improve their attainments. Be careful on sexual abuse, mental and emotional harassment. This is one of the issues. Very fortunately, very few medical teaching professionals still so far has been blamed for. Ours is the noblest profession. If you see from the Hippocrates to our Indian system, Charaka, Indian system, Charaka. Hello. Hello. Hello, are you hearing? Is it clear? Is it clear?
Okay, bro.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Yeah, thank you. As in our Indian ancient medical professional teacher like Charaka, Sushruta, the surgeon. Similarly, we know the Hippocrates. We know the Claudius Galen. We know the Ibn Sina of Arabic countries. These are the great medical teachers who have actually motivated, inspired us, the teaching process centuries or centuries, not only the centuries, but also thousand years. So this we have to follow. We have to see how best we can do it for that. One point besides the students, our obligations towards the students and the society, one most obligation as an ethical teacher, medical teacher, must be with his professional colleagues and his own profession. I have to be a teacher simultaneously. I am also a medical professional doctor. So I have to go for the patient, and also my obligation towards the patient should not be curtailed at any cost. So teaching actually makes the refining, the practice and professionalism. Similarly, professionalism also improves the quality of teaching. This is an interesting part of medical teacher as such. So we are benefited by this direct understanding of teaching and practice simultaneously. In this regard, we must show the respect to our professional colleagues, a professional teacher or a professional doctor himself or herself. We must also improve the ethical sense by interacting with more, attending more seminar, conference, workshop, where we exchange the views. We must see the diversity of our nature, attend the diverse people, part of the different countries or in the same country, different communities and people, and interact, see the patient's care. And that's the reason we require attending such type of gathering which you all are attending today. And the member of the profession, we must show the respects, and definitely we should restrain ourselves from certain obligation, like it is a broad-based, so we must follow the broad-based objective rather than the narrow profile of a single or individualistic teaching itself when the question of medical teaching comes. Another part of the ethical part of a medical teacher, which always we come across, that the how to deal with our authorities. Authority, I want to mean university authority, administrative authority, authority of the national accreditation policy makers, national interest, the national bodies, and international domain and all. And we must cooperate in this regard for formulation of the policies. This policy of the institution, sometimes it may affect one particular domain of a medical teaching. Suppose I am teaching physiology, but it has been shown that the interest of the broader interest of the medical teaching, part of my topic might have been reduced and given it to the other subjects, or imparted some other subject like molecular biology, stem cell, etc., in physiology, or nanomedicine under the reconstructive, regenerative medicine, under the internal medicine. This may make the conventional teachers a little bit shaky. But ethically, we have to accept it, and we have to cooperate with the authorities and change ourselves to the changing scenario of the world as such. And lastly, I want to tell that medical teachers and non-teaching must have a very good rapport with the other non-medical staffs. We have to work with the laboratory technicians, other people who are supporting staffs, IT, who have given a big support for us. We have to cooperate with them. So we must be respectful beside our obligation, ethical views towards the student, patients, community, society, our colleagues. We have to also give equal respect to our colleagues which are not belong to medical professional or not being a medical teacher. So about the parents, obligation to the parents, community, society, I have already discussed. So this is a public domain. Medical doctors, physicians are in public domain. Medical teachers are watched by the society, community, university, students, everybody. So we should be ourselves very careful to behave any of the things which he thinks may be detrimental for our own image as a medical teacher. So the goals, if you come for ethical teaching, we'll be finding philosophy of medicine is the primary goal. We have to sensitize students to value issues, but it should be ethical value itself. Teach moral reasoning and make them understand what is immoral practice, what is morally corrected, must consent to the ourselves, and it is the service towards the nation, countries, and the service towards the humanities. And make the medicine a relationship between patient and doctor should be also taught. How ethically one patient and doctor behave, we must teach them. And medicine in the broader social professional perspective, we must teach. And one thing we must do, don't teach students that ethically what is ethical. They should learn from a teacher's own ethical views and the way he teach and handle the issues, whether it is teaching materials or it's the clinical materials, how they handle that should be taught, and student will understand what is ethically correct. So these are the points I like to tell, just a few headlines. This medical teachers have an ethical dilemma. Always they face whether it should go, how much I should go, because I must teach this part or I must restrain myself because that to be shared by other medical teachers in other curriculum. So this dilemma we have to be very clear, and we must be clearly should know that yes, my knowledge imparting is important at this moment, I must share. And certain matters of hidden medical curriculum should be exposed. Student-teacher relationship I have already explained. Relating educational ethics to biomedical research, another component. Students, medical students observe teachers in the two forum. One as a teacher, other as a practitioners or clinicians teachers. But third point also they notice as a research teacher. So these three are equally important. So they observe the teacher as a researcher, as a teacher, and also as a clinician teacher, where they directly show how to serve the community and the patient itself. So we have to be careful for the research purpose, that how much we must teach and what exactly the ethically correct for doing a research, collecting a data, writing a report, sending the information to the publication, all things should be correctly teach to the students. Everything is important for a medical teacher as such. On being a medical teacher, I must say, maintain a professional barrier between you and students. Refer students to the appropriate resource persons for counseling. If you feel that you are not able to appropriately teach the students or the group of students, you have not successful, bring the right person. Don't think yourself ethically it will be wrong. Even if you try, which you are not able to succeed, must bring the person who will be more authentic, more appropriate for the teaching. Do not flirt with the students. There should be a relationship gap between the teacher and students. And this relation is very auspicious and very, very much it is heavenly. It should be developed. Do not discuss your personal life or personal matters with the students. Do not discuss your spouse, dates, friends, personal problem with the students. When you are teaching in a medical school, in a university, you are totally sacred in the eyes of students. So behave like that. Patients and students think the doctor and the teacher, medical doc teacher, as just the messenger of God. So behave exactly like that. And one thing, you must be very serious. The students should be properly taught. They should be supervised each and every steps. There should not be any things which should distract and should avoid the responsibility. And always be very polite. We must have our own decent informations. Correctly we should come. We should not socialize with the student too much, but definitely we know there are issues and problems, but not the personal issues. And if at all it comes, it must be solved in a very amicable and ethical way, because the relationship is a sacred here. Do not harass the student, respect their differences. This is always we have to do. What you intend as humor may impact the cultural bias or harassment. It happens. When we go to the teaching global perspective, we find that what culture in our Asian country we have, European country does not follow that. They feel it's a cultural gap. Similarly, we also find when a teacher, when the students of Western country, when they enter in their classroom with a cup of coffee in his hand or just simply squat on the floor to listen to you, you feel that you are not supposed to be acquainted with. Yes, it's a cultural gap. So we must know, and to become a global medical teacher, we must come across more and more international exposure for each and every country is required. Western country required for us to know about our culture, and Asian country required the culture of the Western also, and make yourself, because medical profession is a global and it does not have any border. It is a cross-border discipline, only cross-border discipline which ethically allowed a human being to work with others. Hence, I can say A medical educator maintains a professional relationship with each student, both in and outside of the classroom or clinic. After all, you are held to a high moral standard than other professions because of your role in educating tomorrow's doctor. You are held accountable for your private life as well as your public life. Yes, we are the scanner, we are the eyes of the society, what doctors and medical teachers they do. Keep in mind that relatively few medical educators overcommit violation. Yes, I'm extremely proud that in my profession, medical profession definitely has the less violations of ethics have been noticed as a teacher. Most sacred teachers, if you see from the Aristotle to Galen to Ibn Sina to Charaka Susruta, we will be finding they're respected with a very high moral until after centuries and hundreds and thousand years we remember them. Arm yourself with knowledge to avoid violation of standard and don't become one of the statistics. Use common sense and rational judgment to avoid the problems. And you must keep it in the mind always. When we do some works as a teacher, as a professional teacher, or a medical teacher in the bedside, what we are doing, is it fair? Does it uphold the values of the institution where I'm working? Can I tell my decision which I'm taking in a clinical bedside or on the student's his future career? Can I discuss with my superior or my family? How would others regard the details if made public? Because we should be very careful for our this one. Am I confident in my decision? Will it be valid for years? Is it legal? Will it hurt anyone? Does it positively represent positions, profession? Does it make anyone uncomfortable? Does it convey respect for others? Have I involved others by as keen their viewpoint? These are the things I must ask before I execute my work as a medical teacher and a clinical professional. We must ask. If the answer, if I get satisfactory, I must go ahead with that. So, I am coming to the end. Here I must say, the steps to ethical decision making by a medical teacher have the ladder. In this ladder, we'll find first to recognize an ethical issue if it arises, get the fact correctly, evaluate alternative actions before taking any actions by you as a teacher, a medical teacher, whether other part is there or not, whether it is going to be wrong. Make a decision and act as reflect on outcome. Wait, and again, we should get learning by our experience. So the last I want to say from my good friend, Robert Carroll, who has said in his recent Advances in Physiology journal, he has recently visited my university. So I just thought to cite his one of the editorial remark at Advances in Physiology Education journal. There have been a number of events and innovation that have been projected to diminish the importance within bracket or completely replace the teacher in the learning process. Despite information transfer advances within brackets, such as written language, the printing press, image capture, voice capture, and the internet, the teachers remain critical to the formal education process. So why do as teachers still exist? Yes, we exist because we are still required by the society in spite of technology and many other advances, books, everything is there. But our existence depends on our ethical presence in front of the student as the just as the messenger of the humanity to carry forward to our students in the noblest profession in the art. So thank you very much. I wish Robert Carroll, a gratitude to Robert Carroll, Arif Siddiqui, my university, and definitely you all to listen carefully and patiently on my talk. Thank you very much. Thanks for all. Have a nice day. I wish all the grand success of this today's conference.
Thank you so much, bro.
Thank you very much.
For this nice presentation and lecture.
It's really pleasure to be with all of you.
I want to transfer my warm greeting and my colleagues also for your participation in our conference. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I hope we see you in actual world, not
yes,
just
yes. Sure. I
hope we will see you in future.
Yes, Professor Al-Charak, I shall love to come. I shall love to come to your beautiful country.
Some colleagues want to discuss with you. I have some questions.
Right.
But about 15 minutes, we have now to make a break, and then we come back to you.
Okay. You want to again? Shall I be in the online or I will be off?
Within 15 or 30 minutes. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank
right.
you so much.
Okay. Right. You
Thank
come
you
back.
So
again. Thank you.
Thank you. Goodbye.
They'll be asking something.